Can I get it for you? I gotta tell you something. That's a special song for me. That was from my third album. Up to that point, yeah. You know, I made three albums on Motown. Come back from the big After the Storm record. That record was huge. Stayed on the charts for 2.5 years. Soul Train Award. All kind of awards. Well, after the sophomore record in the music business, they go, well, what are you gonna do now? I said, well, I'm here to stay. I wrote this song, Better Days Ahead, and I got a fan letter from a prisoner on death row. Mm. This was probably in 19 now. Yeah. I'm on the 50th floor, some skyscraper in Las Vegas. And back then, we didn't have email and all that. So I've been to my P.O. box, got my fan letters. I'm reading this letter. Brought tears to my eyes. This prisoner on death row, his number had come up. It was his time. He wrote me 4 pages about how that song resolved his spirit, allowed him to face his death, face his maker, apologize, ask for forgiveness, and that he would have better days ahead again. Now, up to that point, I'm like, yeah, man, I had a beautiful life. I love to play the guitar. I'm kind of good at it. I get to play for the world. I thought I was doing what I loved to do and what I was good at. That just shook me a little bit there. This man's, part of his salvation came from this song with no words. I immediately heard words to the melody. I see them too, those better days ahead. You see them too, better days. I said, damn, I didn't hear that before. I read that letter 20 times, and it taught me something. I was chosen. I wasn't doing something I wanted to do. Yeah, it was amazing. I said, damn. What if I had not written that song, and this guy never got to hear that? You know, I took the other meaning to it without. And it blew my mind. And it changed my outlook and my perspective on what I was doing. Then I got scared. A responsibility showed up. I am serving the world in a big way. I helped this guy die and get ready to come back. Then I said, oh shit, that wasn't me. Came through me. That's how big it was. So then that took me back to 8 years old. I come home playing ball one day, Kansas City, on 7th Street. Yes. I'm coming home playing ball. I look up at my house and the yard is full of people. The porch is full of people. And I'm hearing this music coming out of the house. And I go inside. My big brother's sitting there playing the guitar. My mother let him and a drummer and a bass player set up in the living room. And it was a block party. Everybody was happy, partying and feeling good and smiling. I was like, damn, I've been sharing a room with this cat for 8 years. I didn't even know he played the guitar. I heard. I sat there mesmerized on the couch till they finished. Broke it down, I watched everybody. Yeah, thank you, that was great. It's over. We made it through it. I wrote this song during that time. You know, God got mad at us. Made us all go in the house. Y'all ain't treating each other all right. You're not good to each other. Keep recess is over, go inside. Stay in the house until our shit come out. And when you come out, I'm watching you. It was a beautiful thing, actually. Have you ever thought to yourself, man, I wish time would stop for a minute. I don't feel like going to work today. I don't feel like doing nothing today. Guess what? Time stopped for a minute. I found a silver lining in that. I didn't have to fly on an airplane for 2 years. That was pretty nice. But I wrote this song called Let's Get Away. It turned into an album. And it's a double entendre on words. In one sense, it means let's get away from that old negative attitude that we're separate from each other. That I don't need you. That's wrong. Because I am you and you are me. And what I do to you, I do to me. And we've got to remember that. I'm gonna put you back in the house again. Have you ever seen anybody successful by themselves? No, it ain't gonna happen. You see, we are interconnected. We are interrelated. Therefore, we are interdependent on each other. It's called unification. And so when we get with that concept, I think we'll be able to elevate the connection. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. So I wrote this song called Let's Get Away From That Old Mindset. Get with unification. First law of creation. In the other sense, it means let's get with somebody beautiful and go somewhere stupendous and have a warm, wonderfully good time. Tonight, that's San Antonio, Texas. Thank you for having me here tonight. It's a pleasure to be here playing for you. We're gonna do Let's Get Away now for you from our current CD. play the guitar, and I'll give you the keys to the car. Well, I'm probably 11. So I'm like, wow, I can't even drive yet. And then I thought about it, I said, I can't play like Wes either yet. So he would sit down in the basement, y'all, Friday nights, hours, watching me learn how to play like that. That song, I couldn't figure out what Wes was doing. I get that much. But they didn't sound like it. Can't even mean you're missing something. I said, damn. About a year later, I said, oh, he playing two notes at the same time. And he playing on his thumb, not the pick. Woo! He said, boy, you got it now. I think I was about 16, 17 then. I said, damn, he was so proud. He sat there every night, Friday night, watched me do that. Remember how he hated the tuning up part. Tuning the guitar, oh no. Hurry up that thing, what you doing? We gotta do it though. I ended up getting keys to the car. So I learned to play his favorite song. So he invented a whole new style of playing guitar. First with his thumb. Because when he practiced, his wife said it was too loud. Can you turn it down, Wes? It's too loud. Turn it down. He said, no problem, honey. He's doing a way to pick. Sometimes that's thumb. And then he had that octave. Wells was a welder. He worked in a factory. He didn't even start playing the guitar until about 35, so.
Wow.
Incredible. Genius, change the face of guitar. I didn't know all that then, and I'm glad. I learned that Wes. So my sister, I come from a big family, she comes running home, she loves me and loves the guitar, she had this record. Mom, you gotta learn how to play like this now. Now I got Jimi Hendrix and Wes Montgomery. What else could there be? She said, he's singing with the guitar. that's my guitar story. I'm on a history of life. We're born free, we're born to see. See, with the power to choose, I like for my son. Successes achieved by making right choices, taking divine choices, but higher choices, attracting bright resources. Give it to power in you, give it to power in you. That room ain't no free will. Go on! Take a walk with me in heart and peace. As we walk, we talk, we see. It's a beautiful place, beginning our race. And we all come from there. It's home to ourselves, the key, the key. The right time to examine, to reflect, to examine and reflect, so I can realign myself as I state divine.